Welcome to Richard Suttmeyer's 4 in 4. Four blips on my radar screen presented in 4 minutes or less. Today is Tech Tuesday, so my focus is on the technology sector. My first blip looks at the daily and weekly charts for the tech-heavy NASDAQ and the Philadelphia Semiconductor Index, the SOX. The NASDAQ set a new 52-week low at 2169, and this week's support is 2161. The daily chart is not yet oversold. The weekly chart for the NASDAQ shows an oversold condition with the 200-week simple moving average at 2258. The NASDAQ is below its 200-week for the first time since August 2004. The Philadelphia Semiconductor Index, the SOX, is scraping along its January 23rd low of 334.29 and is not yet oversold. The weekly chart for the SOX has been oversold since mid-November and is now 25% below its 200-week simple moving average at 451.20. Monthly and weekly resistances at 351.67 and 352.57. My second blip shows the weakening technicals for Apple and Google as they become more undervalued as share price weakness. Apple is rated a hold according to Value Engine and is 28.8% undervalued, and the weekly chart is oversold. My annual value level is 112.37 with my semi-annual pivot at 130.49. Google set a new 52-week low at 413.04 on Monday, is 34.9% undervalued and oversold on its weekly chart pattern for the first time ever. There's a price gap that provides resistance at the February 25th low, 485.74. My third blip profiles this week's upgrade to buy on Nokia and an update on Texas Instruments. Nokia is above its January 22nd low of 29.50 with my semi-annual value level at 30.29 and annual and quarterly pivots at 36.12 and 36.80. Texas Instruments gave investors a profit warning after the close on Monday. The stock remains a buy. My monthly value level is 27.91 with the January 22 low at 28, semi-annual and quarterly pivots at 31.09 and 31.43, and quarterly resistance or risky level at 33.58. My fourth blip profiles Microsoft, which was downgraded to hold from buy this morning. Microsoft is above its year-to-date low at 26.87, with my annual pivot at 27.71 and quarterly and semi-annual risky levels at 31.15 and 31.37. To sum up the tech sector, there are 99 stocks rated a buy or strong buy that are trading undervalued in the cheapest sector, which is 28.7% undervalued, almost as cheap as it was on average for all of 2002. The price charts certainly look like the popping of a mini tech bubble relative to the plunge from the highs of March 2000 to the lows of October 2002. The difference today is that most major tech names have no debt, plenty of cash, and all of this was the result of the 2000 hype that came to fruition 8 years after the tech bubble popped. Tech stocks had reasonable to excellent Q4 earnings comparisons, but many have been taken to the woodshed and on lowered guidance, which should continue as the economy shifts into recession. My suggested strategy is to buy and trade with a cash hoard of 65%. Send your comments and questions to support at rightsideadvisors.com. That's today's 4 and 4. Enjoy your day.